Hi folks, Michelle Medeiros here. I'm in St. Louis County at the election board's office. And I know some of you have contacted us about questions and concerns when it comes to curbside voting. And so I just wanted to help clarify a couple of things if that applies to you. Of course, it is primary day, and so the polls will be open till 7 o'clock. But if you'd like to vote and may not want to go inside, they are offering curbside. Now, that comes with a lot of exceptions. Let me show you over here. So earlier this week, I talked to the St. Louis County Election Board directors, and they said that they are offering curbside voting. Now, this is not something that's new. This is actually for folks with disabilities. They've offered this for quite a long time, but obviously the situation is a bit different, and with COVID, people are wondering, hey, is this something that can apply to me? So over here in St. Louis County, when I spoke to those election officials, they said they do indeed have curbside voting, and they have done it before. They said they really just don't have the poll workers necessary to continue to do something like this. It does seem like, though, they've gotten quite a bit of demand from the public for it. So they have kind of orchestrated their own thing here. You can see this line of cars, and they've kind of figured out a way to make this happen. You can see absentee ballot drop, that's over here as well. So again, they are trying to accommodate folks, but when it comes to curbside voting, if you did not get an absentee ballot in the mail and you still want to drop it off, you can do so here at the county headquarters. Now, if you did not get a ballot in the mail and you'd like to come and vote today, they said that you can go ahead and just ask someone, if you maybe want to ask a stranger, but just direct someone to one of the poll workers and say, hey, there's somebody outside that'd like to vote absentee. Now, St. Louis City has a little bit different of a setup. They actually have a little buzzer outside the entrance where if you wanted to vote curbside, they have a little button and a little station that you can push. It'll alert the election judges, and then they can send someone out to help you. Now, not everybody is doing this for folks that have concerns over COVID. However, if you have a disability, St. Charles County will allow you to vote curbside, but that's only if you're a person with disabilities. So if you have any questions or concerns, they say call your election headquarters. Now, that's wherever you live, you call that specific election headquarters. And if you think that something is questionable or have some concerns that you feel like aren't adequately being addressed, I did speak to the Missouri Voter Protection Coalition. They have said that across the state of Missouri, you should have curbside voting. Now, they've always had curbside voting. That's for folks with disabilities. Different places are handling it different ways. And again, it may not be as obvious as a place like in St. Louis City. They have a literal button stuck to a pole that you push. Here in St. Louis County, they said you'd have to kind of flag someone down and ask for it. It sounds like St. Charles County, as I mentioned, is doing it only for folks with disabilities. They're not kind of giving that exception to people that might have some hesitation because of the coronavirus. But you can see a pretty steady flow out here in St. Louis County. It's been this way for most of the day. They are still doing the absentee ballot drop-off. And so I actually talked to the Missouri Voter Protection Coalition this afternoon. They said early on this morning they were getting some calls for various reasons. They said a couple of the polling places opened a little late this morning, so they got a few calls about that. They also said that they had a police presence at some of the polls, and they got some calls about that. They said police, you know, are allowed to be there, but they shouldn't be intimidating in any way, shape, or form. They shouldn't be blocking an entrance or congregating in any area. So they did get a couple calls about that. She had said that, you know, those situations of the police presence as well as the opening a bit late, those have all been rectified. She did say that there were some questions, and I heard from a couple of voters that said that particular person was from Florissant. There was a ballot measure. He noticed that, he's like, I don't think it's on here. I went and I flagged them to that. and they've reprinted me another ballot. The woman with the Missouri Voter Protection Coalition said she did get quite a few phone calls about that. Folks, especially if you're voting absentee and you're kind of guiding yourself through that process, be very sure that you're filling out both sides. The ballot itself may be double-sided. So she said if you're voting and you're putting it in the ballot machine, the electronic one here, it will actually flag you and it'll say, hey, you left one of these unanswered. Is that your intention? So you can leave things unanswered, she says, but most times it's kind of just one of those red flags like, hey, did you really mean to do this? And that is something that you can do when you're here at the polls. But of course, if you mailed it in, you just have to keep a really close eye on that. Now, another thing, I did talk to a gentleman that said he was out here and he wanted to not wear a mask. It sounds like they did try to accommodate him through different methods. He didn't choose to do any of those methods. They said he could come to this facility in St. Anne, and if he was concerned about it actually getting to the ballot box, he could do curbside voting, and they would actually bring out the ballot box to him. He's like, I don't know if I want to drive that far. That was his own choice. But they were trying to accommodate him. A lot of the places, you know, I talked to, like I said, the Missouri Voter Protection Coalition, and she said, you know, they can't deny someone the right to vote. So as long as they offer you alternative methods and you have the ability to vote, really that you know, that's not in question. But they do ask that if you, you know, don't want to wear masks, that's fine, but you have to vote curbside. That's at least what that location was offering him as a solution. So just be mindful of that. Again, polls are open till 7 o'clock tonight. And I will have a recap on what's going on out here in St. Louis County, as well as elsewhere throughout the area. And I thank you for joining me. Be safe and go vote.